Hello from Chem Help ASAP. Let's see how one estimates a value called Cp0 from the Cp time data from an IV bolus. In previous videos, we saw Cp time curves like this IV bolus. Note that the plot on the left has a beautiful curve that goes all the way back to time zero. We can clearly see the distribution phase and how high Cp is at time zero. This is called Cp0 and is the same as Cp max for this curve. In practice, however, IV bolus curves don't look like this. Normally the injection is performed and then there is a delay before the first Cp time data point. The distribution phase is normally complete before that first data point. The result looks more like this graph on the right, and the distribution phase is almost completely missed in the data. In order to estimate the intersection of the graph with the y-axis at time zero, called Cp0, we need to do some extrapolation. This extrapolation is a lot easier if we use a natural log Cp time graph instead. Okay, here are the same two graphs from the previous slide, but they show natural log Cp time instead. Our job is to extrapolate the natural log Cp time curve on the right back to the y-intercept. That's exactly our process. We're going to extrapolate this line. Note that this is why the natural log Cp time curve is easier for this purpose. The graph is essentially linear. So it's a simple extrapolation of a line. So we're going to look at our natural log Cp time data points, determine the y-intercept for our line. So as a line, this will be y equals mx plus b. B is our y-intercept, and that will be natural log of Cp0. Our estimated Cp0 will be determined by taking the inverse log of our y-intercept. Our estimated Cp0 will be lower than the value for the curve on the left because we're missing this. That's natural log. The distribution phase. Regardless, our estimate will be good enough for our needs. In the table on the left are our natural log Cp time data points for our graph. Note that the time points do not begin until 0.5 hours. This is after the distribution phase for most molecules. Spreadsheets have a great function called intercept that will determine the y-intercept without requiring us to do a full best fit calculation. So in an open cell, we can type equals intercept, as we see on this top line, and then select our y values from column C, that's our natural log Cp values, add a comma followed by our x values from column A. Hit return, and there is the number. This intercept is 1.39. That is our natural log Cp0. For the inverse natural log, just type equals exp with our y-intercept in parentheses, hit return, and our Cp0 is 4.03. If the y-axis had units, then those would be the units on Cp0. Something like micrograms per liter or nanograms per milliliter would be typical. Cp0 is an extrapolated value that we will use for the determination of other PK parameters. I hope this video was helpful for you. Please subscribe, like, or leave a comment or question. Take care.